focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.
Welcome to Make India Diabetes Free, presented by Fortune Vivo and TV18. Now, last week we had a great time cooking some really great food, healthy food and diabetic friendly food. We also had actress Soha Ali Khan, who came, ate with us and shared her insights into how she lives a healthy life. Today, we're going to have more of the same. We're cooking up some great stuff for you. We also have actress Gulpanag, who's joining us. The dishes we are going to cook today starts with an extremely, unbelievably healthy ingredient. It's called zucchini. So what we're going to make today are zoodles. Now you'll ask me, what are zoodles? I've never heard of zoodles. Well, zoodles are noodles which are made out of zucchini. Zucchini is a healthy vegetable. Zoodles are gluten-free and they also increase the amount of vegetables in your diet, which we normally don't do. So let's start making zoodles. They're made exactly like the way you'd make noodles and they're as tasty. Now let's take one green zucchini. So let's keep the recipe very, very simple and retain the integrity and all the nourishment of the zucchini. We're going to do a simple aglio olio. Yeah, let's start with some Fortune Vivo, wonderful Fortune Vivo oil, instead of using any other oil. This is healthy and diabetic friendly. Let the oil warm up a little bit and I'm going to add basic, lovely Italian garlic. To this, I'm going to add a little splash of water. As the garlic starts browning, I'm adding freshly chopped, finely chopped red chili. Little bit of salt. And what I have over here is Italian seasoning. Nice, wonderful flavors. And this is tossed and ready. Now, let's serve it up. This is our zucchini, which is ready, our zoodles, which are ready, aglio olio style. And with this, I'm going to make some wonderful, wonderful grilled prawns. Since we've done the zoodles with the taste of garlic and red chilies, I think we should do the prawns with something a little more interesting. How about we use orange zest? Let's start the marinade. You may ask me, prawns? Aren't prawns supposed to be high cholesterol? Well, if you're already on a diabetic-friendly diet, you're eating low-fat food throughout the week. So prawns once a week, once in a while, a little bit of cheating is wonderful. It's still white meat. Let's start with some Fortune Vivo healthy oil. Some salt, garlic, smoked paprika. And now, the orange. Now for some orange juice. Stir this up a bit. I've got these small bamboo skewers. Okay, the prawns are skewered. Let's put some healthy Fortune Vivo oil in the pan. And I think this pan is now ready for the prawns. This is the wonderful things about prawns. They cook really quickly. So the zoodles are ready, and so are the prawns. Now we put them together with a little bit of balsamic and they're ready to eat. But wait, we've got one more dish coming up. From Italy, let's move to France. The next dish we're making is a healthy vegetable stew. It's called ratatouille and it originated in Nice, also made famous by the animation film of the same name. We're going to use a lot of zucchini, a lot of tomato, and also a tomato sauce. So let's first start by making the sauce. And for that, I need some onions and tomatoes. Let's start cooking them. Some fortune weaver oil. Let's start with some garlic. And to this I'm adding some fresh basil leaves and some fresh oregano. Some celery. I've got some finely chopped carrot over here. And now some onion. Let this cook for a little while. I can see the onions cook, slightly translucent. We don't need them to go brown. I'm going to add in the tomatoes here. We'll add some water. So the tomatoes and onions are now nicely done and cooked. The sauce is nearly ready. All we need to do is put it into a blender. And I've already got some sauce that I made earlier, which I've pulled through a blender, and this is what it looks. So we've got our sauce ready for the ratatouille. Now let's start doing the vegetables. So these are the three things we're going to use in the ratatouille. Two kinds of zucchini and tomato. Now that our vegetables are ready, nicely sliced, let's start putting it all together. So, sauce at the bottom of the pan, and now let's start with our vegetables. So once the vegetables are laid out nicely with the sauce below, you put it into the oven at 180 degrees for 5 to 7 minutes, maybe 8, just till the color of the zucchini changes. Into the oven. While the ratatouille is in the oven, let's quickly recap. So the ratatouille is now out of the oven. The color has changed slightly, just ever so slightly. The ratatouille and the tomato and all the vegetables are still fresh and crisp. All we've got to do is finish this off with a little bit of Parmesan and a little bit of parsley. Ba-ba-dee, ba-do-be-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do And this table is looking really attractive because not only is there some lovely food on the table, the company is terribly, terribly attractive. We've got actor-entrepreneur Gul Panag, everybody knows who she is, joining us today. And with her, for some really serious information, we've got Madhuri Ruya, who's a nutritionist and fitness entrepreneur. Now, that was a whole mouthful. I was hoping that my mouthful would be full of food. But y'all are highly qualified for today's subject, and I'm glad to have you here.
Thank you for having us.
Now,
thank you.
Before we even start chatting, please, can I tell you what we have on the table?
Yes.
Yeah? The plan today is to eat diabetic-friendly food.
Okay.
Diabetes-friendly food. And I have cooked this, wow. And I hope you like it. We've got zucchini, noodles made out of zucchini, which are zoodles.
Zoodles, okay.
And this is a ratatouille. So here we go. Let's eat and talk healthy. Can I start with you, Gul? By the nature of your profession, looking good is something that it's a given, you know. You
right.
have to look good, look healthy, skin has to look glowing. What do you do specifically? What do you do to sort of, you know, keep yourself healthy and looking good?
I'm very cognizant about what I eat. Okay. So that doesn't mean I'm paranoid. It doesn't mean I do fad diets. I'm just aware that my body has X amount of energy requirements. Mm. And I try and remain within that requirement. I know that if I exceed that requirement, I'm going to have weight gain. Mm. And I know that if I eat lesser than that, then I'm going to be malnourished and, you know, low in energy and tired all the time. Mm. So I try and balance my energy requirements with what I put into my body. Mm. And I try and make sure that I have at least 35, 40 minutes of exercise every day.
So how do you then define healthy food, you know? Because we always talk about healthy means low fat, healthy means, you know, eating less, healthy mm-hmm. means eating only these things. So what makes food healthy?
Well, to begin with, let's just assume that, you know, the chemistry on your plate becomes a chemistry in your body. Mm. So, you know, the more natural the food is, the more color there is, there has to be some healthy fats because, you know, our organs, especially the brain, is 50%, 60% is made up of healthy fats, which come from oils. So, you know, eliminating all the oils is not a good idea.
It's not a good idea.
Not at all a good idea because oils bring with them vitamins A, D, E, and K that help us to absorb nutrients in the zoodles, for example.
Mm. I think also listening to how your body reacts to various
right.
foods is very, very important. For example, something may be really healthy for someone, but it may not agree with you.
That's so true. There's no
the
one
quote,
size
unquote,
fits all. Yeah.
A healthy food for you. For example, chickpeas. I mean, chickpeas is hummus. It's you know, you make boiled chaat and everything with it. It doesn't agree with me. I feel uncomfortable
so
after
no
eating.
So no chana bhatura?
No. Both because of no chana. I mean, it's not like I won't have it once in a while, but I don't think I'll make it part of my staple. So what is my regular food? I think my goal is to hit my protein, carbohydrate and fat requirement every day.
Is oil a villain actually?
It is not,
and
not
two,
at all.
Is,
in fact, we
are there good oils, bad oils? What kind of oil for diabetes specifically?
Yeah.
Do we sort of
so
use?
Let me answer this at several levels. One, okay. you know, at the cellular level, that means at our cellular level, the cell walls are made up of protein and fats and not carbohydrate and oil. So that is why we need that, because the cell, when the cell wall is strong, it means that all the in, you know, the bacteria, viruses cannot penetrate it, and we feel really good. And oil carries with it vitamins A, D, E, and K. Apart from that, there are certain oils that have gamma oresinol and you know, lignans, like sesame has sesame lignans, and these really help in increasing insulin sensitivity, which is the key for diabetics.
This is also, again, it's just
lots of
purely vegetables, yeah, antioxidants. Yeah.
So I do a glass of veggie juice every morning, which has a minimum of 3 vegetables. The idea behind that is I want to just check the green box, because
check
I don't
mark.
Know the access to fiber I'm going to have if I'm traveling out of the day.
So
my breakfast is usually in my control, and even if I'm leaving at a godforsaken hour like 6 o'clock in the morning.
India seems to be at the moment the capital of diabetes.
Absolutely.
It's a killer.
It's a killer.
And so
because we are extremely insulin resistant because of our lifestyle. As a race, because also we're very sedentary. The scarier thing for me about diabetes is there's a condition called pre-diabetes.
Right.
So
which
diabetes doesn't happen overnight.
Right.
You
right.
have to. It takes several years of doing the wrong thing to pile up. I mean, the body really wants us to be healthy, but it takes several years for diabetes to actually culminate into full-blown type 2 diabetes. So if we are not diabetic and we are not looking after our lifestyle, then we are mostly pre-diabetic.
And pre-diabetes is reversible, Madhuri.
I would say it can be kept in remission, yes, 100%.
And not go into full-blown diabetes?
Yes, okay. Yes. Even if you have full-blown diabetes, you can get it back into remission.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's all very positive. I like to look at that side of things.
So if I had a plate,
I would fill half of it with vegetables that are cooked, lightly grilled and cooked like this, and maybe a heaping of salad on the top of it.
Okay.
If I could, you know, if I, then this would be like the carb portion. Let's take this.
Half of that.
Yeah. So this would be my carb portion. And I'll put the prawns that we finished eating.
Okay.
Right here. Okay. The other things that come on this side of the plate are potatoes, peas and corn.
This side.
So what group
this
is
one,
that?
This one. The carb group. Potatoes, peas and corn. Can I exchange that with bread? Yeah, so you choose one of those.
Ah, okay.
See, typically we would have roti with aloo matar ki sabzi.
Which is the same group again and again.
That is lethal.
Ah.
It's like a vada pav.
All of this has to be cooked in healthy oil. It should not be something that's just boiled. Hmm. Please, we don't want to have only boiled food, because without the healthy oil, we're not going to be able to absorb, you know, all the phytonutrients that are the nutrients, the micronutrients that vegetables give us.
Okay, before we end this conversation, I want both your opinions on... Mm-hmm. The food that we have today, okay?
Health-wise, I would give it like a 10 on 10 because, ooh, yeah, there's zoodles, which is really good, a low starch, high fiber, very good for insulin sensitivity, in the sense that it's not going to increase your insulin levels. Tomatoes have lots of color and antioxidants, and the sauce is yummy, and the prawns were really good because I love the natural omega-3 in them, and I think it's really good. It's cooked in healthy oil, I would imagine, yeah, which is also adding to the antioxidant value.
So firstly, presentation, I know my plate doesn't look very presentable now, but when we started out, it looked amazing. it looks very appetizing, it looks very inviting, so I love the way it looks. I really enjoy the zoodles, they're crunchy. As you can see, I've eaten more than the two. It's taken a while to eat, and I think that's also a good thing, because the slower you eat, the better it is. And it tastes really good. So for me, this is a revelation. I'm going to take a picture of this.
So thank you, Gul. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kunal.
Thank you, Madhuri. this was just our little attempt of trying to get India to be diabetes free.
Amen to that.
Let's amen to that. And on that note,
let's attack food.
Dig in.
Focus. Ideate. Innovate. Enable.